let sense any element of weakness, they're going to pounce onto it. Like an alpha might do to a good-looking woman if she was in the mood. There you go.
Alright, maybe second most hated. Before I start, the guy I'm talking about today is a very political guy. You might want me to get political, I'm not getting political. I don't want to do it. My only political stance is that I'm on your side. Thank you. Nick Adams, Trump's favorite author, Australian by birth, American by choice, and self-proclaimed alpha male. That blurb alone should tell you plenty about what his Twitter looks like. Let's dive in anyways. Right off the bat, we get a gem of a pin tweet. Yes, I am more successful and attractive than you. No, I will not be apologizing for it. Attached is a picture of a fairly normal dude. What was the exigence for this tweet? I don't think anyone actually asked him if he was more successful and attractive than them, and I definitely don't think they asked for an apology afterwards. If God didn't want women to cook, why did he put milk in their bodies? Makes you think. No, it doesn't. Nick Adams got a lot of attention for his stance on Hooters back in 2022, stating that alpha males eat wings and drink beer at Hooters with the boys, beta males nibble on tapas at Spanish-speaking cafes with their wives, and that Hooters is a safe space where alpha males can bond together and be alphas without the socialist feminist beta left getting in the way. Listen, man. You can say that you just like looking at women. Is it a little creepy? Sure. But let's not pretend it's because the socialist feminist beta left is mobbing you at any other sports bar. You have the most forgettable face and name of anyone that I've ever seen. You will be fine. He came into the limelight a bit more recently, however, when he posted this image captioned, "Hanging out with Tim Robbins at JFK." Pretty impressive, right? I mean, this is Tim Robbins we're talking about. Star of The Shawshank Redemption, Academy Award winner, and Bernie Sanders supporter. Doesn't exactly go with Nick Adams' whole vibe, but, you know, that's alright. Surely they can overlook political differences in the name of friendship. But as you look at the whole post, things do look a bit strange. First of all, why are they hanging out at an airport? Who has ever called up their friend and said, "Hey man, you free? Yeah, I was just wondering if you wanted to grab the worst food you've had in your life at LAX." And why does it look like Tim just took out his earbuds just to take the picture? So it didn't make perfect sense. And unsurprisingly, Tim Robbins responded to the tweet saying, "Not hanging out. Dude asked for a picture. I obliged. He left." Which received about 75 times more likes than his tweet. Now this humiliated Nick, prompting him to respond with this rant. "It's true that Tim Robbins and I were not hanging out like friends would. Alpha males are not friends with beta Hollywood liberals. The truth is, when Tim saw me out at the airport, I didn't even recognize him. Let me put it this way, if The Shawshank Redemption had a sequel, they would have to recast Andy Dufresne. The failing actor began pouring his heart out to me in tears about how he can't get any work. I told Tim to clean himself up and that he was embarrassing me. That's when I offered to take a photo with him and post it on my massive Twitter, much larger than his, to cheer him up and get rid of him. That's the last time I tried to do something nice for a woke Hollywood liberal." That story is a little bit hard to believe for a few reasons. Mainly because, well, look at him. Does he look like he just poured his heart out in tears to Nick here? Of course not. It looks like he was just minding his own business, waiting for his flight and listening to music when Nick came up and begged for a picture. One thing that Nick never stops talking about is foursomes. Start off the day in church, then head to the golf course for an 18-hole foursome and end the day at Hooters with the boys. Every man should spend their Sunday like this. Foursome with the boys, domestic beer in the cart, ladies away at the par three, they hate this. Obviously, he's referring to golf foursomes. That... oh my god, were you thinking of... oh no, gross, you're weird. Every once in a while, he says something somewhat sensible. Hey, maybe he's not wrong about everything. Then he posts something like this. And you're brought back to reality. When you scroll through Nick's feed, you realize incredibly quickly that it is impossible for all these thoughts to occur to a person's mind in any sort of sincere manner. A few weeks ago, I went on a date. Naturally, I ordered for the table. We started off light with foie gras and caviar. The conversation was good, but the foie gras was better. For our mains, I ordered the 30-ounce, 100-day dry-aged porterhouse with lobster tail, and I ordered the mixed green salad with a light balsamic vinaigrette for Jordan. What a gentleman. My steak was fantastic, and the salad looked fine, but the lobster was the main event. My date kept asking me how my steak and lobster were, which was a little irritating, but I appreciated the interest in my meal. We finished up and headed back to Jordan's place. On the drive back, I turned on some Lee Greenwood to help set the mood. As we got closer to our destination, my alpha male senses started tingling. Something was horribly wrong, but I couldn't figure out what. I turned up God Bless the USA to try to shake off the bad feeling, but it didn't work. I rounded a bend, and then I saw one of my greatest fears out of the corner of my eye. A row of wind turbines on the horizon. I was horrified and slammed on the brakes, screeching to a halt and startling my date in the passenger seat. "What happened? Are you okay?" Jordan exclaimed. I pulled off to the side of the road and shut off the car. I stepped out and pointed to the turbines. "What the hell is this? Why didn't you tell me about this? What the hell is wrong with you?" I demanded to know.
"What? The windmills? Why does that matter?" Jordan asked, seemingly perplexed by my justified outrage.
I was flabbergasted and furious. I told Jordan I wouldn't go one foot further towards those cancerous bird genocide machines under any circumstances. She was profusely apologetic. You could see the pained look on her face as she came to grips with fumbling an alpha male in such a careless fashion. I told her I appreciated the sincere apology, but the damage had already been done. I asked her to step out of my car, call an Uber, and lose my number. I started to drive home, still shaken from the night's events, when my phone rang. It was Mario, letting me know he was linking up with some masculine guys at Hooters and wanted to see if I would be the guest of honor for the evening. Naturally, I accepted. I needed a testosterone pick-me-up, and domestic beers with the boys were exactly what the doctor ordered. Things always work out for alpha males. Nick Adams has a bunch of little Twitter gimmicks to boost his engagement. One of my favorite ones is that every week he names one very lucky Twitter user the Alpha Male of the Week. This week's Alpha Male of the Week is Philip Oliver Holes, who is a hard R Republican and a landlord rights activist. Now, this account is very clearly satire, just like Nick's. Tweets like this and many others might make you question whether or not this entire account is a joke. Personally, I have never been more confused as to whether an account is satire or not in my life, and I doubt I ever will be again. Now, it might seem obvious that this is a joke account to you, but hold on for a moment. Though his entire Twitter feed is completely outlandish, if you look a little bit closer, he's involved with a few companies that shift my whole perspective on this thing. For example, his own company, Flag USA, which is a non-profit that's supposed to educate children about the American dream, provides resources such as a booklet to destroy critical race theory. It also has the Patriotic Boycotts Initiative, which is meant to boycott anti-American companies, such as Subway for including a leftist soccer player in their advertisements. Those are their words, not mine. So if he has a company dedicated to this, he clearly holds these same beliefs that he's kind of making fun of. So why is he making fun of them, or is he trying to make fun of them at all? There's a few different possibilities that I could see being true here. One, somehow this account is genuine and he's just insane. Two, much more likely, he is real, but he's saying outlandish things to get more engagement and drive traffic to his affiliated companies. 3, the account is run by someone completely unaffiliated with Nick and is making fun of him and just bought the Twitter verified checkmark. While it would be funnier if it was real, it's almost definitely not. Thank you for watching all the way to the end, I really appreciate it. Like, comment, subscribe, you know the deal. Thanks for being here and have a good one.